Hello friends, welcome to Geeks for Geeks. In this video, we are given a problem that is to find the next sparse number. Let us first understand what do we exactly mean by the sparse number. An integer is said to be sparse if it does not have two adjacent set bits, that is continuous ones in its binary form. For example, 5 has the binary representation of 101, hence it is a sparse number. While 6 in binary is expressed as 110, that is, it has two adjacent set bits and hence it is not a sparse number. Now, our task is, given the integer x, we need to find the next sparse number greater than or equal to x. For example, if x is equals to 6, then the output is the next sparse number, that is 8. For x equal to 4, the output is 4 because 4 is itself a sparse number. Again, if x is equals to 38, then the output is 40. And for x equal to 44, the output is 64. Here it should be noted that 8, 4, 40 and 64 are the sparse numbers. Now, the question arises, how can we solve the given problem efficiently? Let's go through the simple solution first and then check out for the possible efficient approach. A simple solution to this problem one can suggest is to iterate over all the integers starting from the given integer x and check each integer whether it is an sparse or not. For example, if x equal to 6 is given as input, then we first check 6. Since 6 is not sparse, so we check 7. Again, 7 is not an sparse, so we check 8. Since 8 comes out to be a sparse number, we return 8 as an output. Now let's quickly go through the implementation for this approach. Here we first make the utility function named isSparse, which returns true if the integer passed as an argument is an sparse number and otherwise false. Having this, we iterate over all the integers starting from the given integer x in the while loop till we find the sparse number. The complexity analysis of this approach is as follows. Since the function is a sparse, iterates over all the bits in the given integer to be checked, the function takes theta of log x in time. And we call this function a maximum of x number of times, hence this takes the time complexity of the order of x into log of x. On the other hand, since our space does not grow with the input integer, hence space complexity remains big O of 1. Again, the question arises, that is, can we make this more efficient? Now let's make some observations to derive the efficient solution. Consider the same examples again. First take input as 6. Here we see that 6 has two adjacent set bits at second and third positions, while in 8 we make these adjacent set bits in 6 as 0 and update the next bit at fourth position as 1. Similarly, in 44, we have two adjacent set bits at third and fourth positions, so we make them 0 and update the next bit on the fifth position as 1. But after doing this, we get the adjacent set bits at fifth and sixth positions again, and hence we make them 0 and update the next position, that is the 7th position, as 1, which gives us 64 as the output. I hope this has given you some broad idea about the algorithm. So now let's go through the algorithm itself. The algo says, first store the binary bits of the given integer in the Boolean array and initialize the last final variable as 0. So that it points to the least significant bit of the given integer x. Now, start traversing the array from LSB to the MSB unless we find the two adjacent ones and also whose next bit is 0. When we find this arrangement, then what we do is we first update the next bit as 1 and unset all the bits to the right of this bit till the last final position. At last, we update the next bit as the position of the last final bit variable. We repeat this till we have traversed all the bits. In the end, we have the sparse number. To make it clear, let's consider an example. Here we have the given binary representation as the input and last final variable as pointing to the LSB. Now we find the two adjacent ones with the next bit as 0 here. These are highlighted as green. Now what we do is we update the next bit as 1 and make all the bits to its right till the LSB as 0. Since we had the last final variable as 0 initially. After this, we make the next bit as the last final bit. Again, we get the two adjacent ones marked as green. So we first set the next bit to 1 and make all other bits to its right till the last final bit as 0. Since there are no more adjacent set bits on the left now, we have found the next sparse number. Let's quickly go through the code for this approach. Here we have the function named nextSparse, which returns the nextSparse number. To make it clear, we have splitted the implementation in 3 different steps. In step 1, we store the binary representation of the given integer in the vector named bin of type boolean. Here we run a while loop which iterates over all the bits of x and store these bits in the vector bin. Each time we write shift x by 1 so as to update the least significant bit in x. Then we initialize the variable n as the size of the vector and last final variable as 0. This last final variable gives the position of the previous updated bit. Moving on to step 2, what we do is we process the bits stored in the boolean vector bin. Here we run a for loop from I equal to 1 to n minus 1, that is the size of the vector bin. At each bit, we check the previous bit for 1 and next bit as 0. This checks the presence of the adjacent set bits with the next bit as 0. If we find this, then we first set the next bit as 1 and run a for loop from j equal to I, that is the current position, until the last final bit position and make every bit we encounter as 0. Finally, we update the last final variable with the next bit, that is I plus 1. In the third step, we convert the transformed binary representation into the decimal number by running a for loop from I equal to 0 to n minus 1. In every iteration, we multiply the current bit with the 2 raised to the power of current position I. This can be calculated by left shifting 1 by the I times. Finally, we add this product to the answer variable, which was initialized with 0. At last, we return this answer variable as the output, that is the next sparse number. The complexity analysis of this approach is as follows. Since the loop iterates over all the bits in the given integer x, and x has log of x bits in its binary representation, the algorithm takes theta of log x in time. And since our space requirements remain constant throughout, the space complexity remains big O of 1. I hope you have clearly understood the 2 ways in which we can find the next sparse number for a given integer. Thanks for watching. Please leave us your comments.